Don't think I'm going to be able to do 20 of these. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today's video is going to be a HIIT home workout, fat burning, full body. It's one of the things I get asked most about and something that actually I don't do a lot of. Now, apparently just being subscribed on YouTube is no longer enough. So make sure you hit the bell somewhere down below here to make sure you get my notifications of when I've got a new video up to ensure that you don't miss anything. HIIT workouts are really good at targeting your fat stores. Therefore, if you were looking to get your body to the beach, kind of summer body thing, if you're on this, gonna get fit for summer, this is a great workout. You can do it in the home, you can do it at the end of your weight session in the gym, or if you're away on holiday and don't have access to a gym, this is a really good way of keeping your body kind of ticking over. HIIT is a really good way of incorporating strengthening work into your cardiovascular workouts. If you're worried about losing any muscle mass while you're upping your cardio in order to shed a little bit of body fat, this is a really good way of doing stuff without losing any muscle mass, because it's using a lot more of your muscles and has got strengthening exercises within it, and you're going to continue to burn those calories after the workout while your body's still healing. On average, your body uses 5 calories per liter of oxygen that is consumed by the body. If you're using more muscles, your body's going to need more oxygen, therefore it's going to consume a higher level or a higher liter percentage of oxygen, therefore you're going to be burning more calories. Make sense? A HIIT workout. So all that means is you've got a short period of exercise followed by a short period of rest and repeated lots of times. I'm aiming to do 20 reps of each exercise, but it's absolutely killing me. But you can also do it on time, or you can do it on your perceived intensity. You need to kind of work to your level of what you find hard. Don't go off, oh, I did it with my friend, she found it really easy, I'm dying. It's what you're going on. They need to make it harder for them because they're not going to be doing that high intensity. They need to do more reps, put more effort in, make the exercises more complex. Whereas for you, you're already working at that level. Does that make sense? Today I'm going to do reps. So I'm going to do about 20 reps of each exercise. One that you can do at home. It doesn't need any equipment and can be done within about 20 minutes and should make you sweat. I've just practiced, which is why I'm a little bit out of breath. Make sure you warm up before. Make sure you've got a nice big space. These exercises are kind of almost 2 exercises in one. I wanted to make it really hard, but beginners or people that are new to exercise might find this routine a little bit harder than others. So if you want, you can just break it down into, so for example, just the squat jumps rather than moving your legs in and out as well at the same time. And first exercise is squat jumps, and then with your legs going in and out, and it involves using a resistance band. So I said no equipment. I don't class as equipment because this is a staple item in my gym bag. This is knackered. I've had it for years. It's got rips in it, but it still works fine. You can get them really cheap off Amazon. You don't need to go spending 20 quid on one thing, one band. You can get them for £3, £5. They work perfectly. You're gonna place the resistance band just above your knee, so kind of bottom of the thigh. And then all you're gonna do is jump, squat down, and then bring your legs together. So, and then 20 reps. The next exercise, I don't really know what I've called it, but basically you get into the plank position and then you drop your hips out to either side, and then you're going to go up into a burpee. So into the plank position, then onto your forearms, and you're going to dip your hips to each side, and then you're going to come up into a burpee and then up. 20 lots of those. Okay, so the next exercise is going to be into that same plank position, up and down onto your arms, and then into a mountain climber, times 20. You're gonna get into that plank position,
And then you're gonna go down to your arms, and then you're gonna bring your knees in, and then back up, times 20.
Blowing, absolutely blowing. Okay, so the next one you're gonna do is what I call a duck walk. So it's a bit like a clam when you go sideways, but you're gonna go frontwards. I'm gonna pop this resistance band on. So we're gonna go two walks forward into a squat jump and then two walks back. And that counts as two reps times 20. God, I'm so out of breath. Place this just above your knees and then we're gonna go down. I'm gonna take my socks off because I keep sliding over. You're gonna go down into the squat position and you're gonna walk forward, one, two, and go up into squat jump and down. Okay, so I need two exercises to go. Remember, I'm doing, well, I said 20, so I only managed 15, but 10 to 20 reps on each station, 30 second rest in between, and then you're gonna repeat it three times, but still got two exercises to go. The next one is just power lunges. Everyone knows lunge position, so each time you go down, you wanna be coming down into this position. Knee, not over your toes, and then a little bend in this knee, and then upper body nice and straight, none of this. You're just gonna alternate in between each side. So one rep to each side, so 10 reps. You go down. And then the next one is just going to be quick feet or running on the spot, then into a press up. Couple more seconds. Okay, this one, I come down into a slight squat position. Don't think I'm going to be able to do 20 of these. Then you're just going to be running on the free into a press up. Running on the spot. Remember, when we're doing a press up, I'm so done. Hands about shoulder width apart, in line with your shoulders. You don't want them all the way back here. Then you're gonna bring your legs out into that nice flat position. And then you're gonna go down into a press up, and then back up again. If you find that too hard, go down onto your knees, same position, and then do it from there. Okay. So, six exercises, times three. 30 second rest in between. Yeah, repeated three times, but in between each set of six, take a minute's rest. Make sure you're getting on lots of water. That should take no longer than 20 minutes. And I'm blowing, and I did it twice. The only thing that I may recommend is in between each exercise, when you're taking your 30 seconds rest, try and keep it nice and active. So just walk around, don't just necessarily stop. I mean, I know I'm stopping, but it's because I'm talking to you guys, but then I'm showing you the next exercise purely because this type of exercise builds up a lot of waste products, so like lactic acid and hydrogen ions. Therefore, it's really important that we keep these washing away to remove these products to allow us to then work to our maximum on the next exercise. Otherwise, you're just going to get a build up and not going to be able to perform to your high intensity on the next exercise. Some people then like to finish with three sets of a finisher exercise, but I'm done, no more for me. If you want a recommendation of where to get any resistance bands, I will link a couple below. Some cheaper, some slightly higher end range ones. I will also drop all of the exercises down below Some of them, I don't really know if they've got a name, so I'm just gonna kind of make something up. But yeah, if you've got any questions, drop them down below. Don't forget to press that bell and make sure you subscribe for my future videos. Thanks for watching, bye bye.